Hello everyone, I am John of the Technology Communication Management Program here in USTP CDO Campus, and welcome to this video lecture series in Introduction to Communication. At the end of this short video, basically viewers are expected to define communication. In addition, viewers should be able to explain briefly why information is not communication, and as well as the significance of being other-oriented in the process of communication. The word communication is one of those words that seems so basic, yet you may wonder why it needs to be formally defined. Yet scholars who devote their lives to studying communication don't always agree on its definition. One research team counted more than 126 published definitions. In its broadest sense, communication is the process of acting on information. Someone does or says something and others think or do words as they understand them. Some scholars question whether any human behavior is really communication. When you cross your arms while listening to your friend describe her day, this may indicate to your friend that you're not interested in what he or she is talking about. But it could be that you're cold. While all human expression has the potential to communicate a message, it does not mean you intentionally are expressing an idea or emotion. Presenting information to others does not mean communication has occurred. Remember, information is not communication.
But I told you what to do!
It's there in the memo. Why didn't you do what I asked? It's in the syllabus!
These irritated communicators assume that if they sent a message, someone would receive it. However, communication does not operate in a simple, linear process. People don't always accurately interpret the messages we express. This unprofound observation has profound implications. One reason we have communication courses, academic departments that focus on communication such as TCM, and people who earn PhDs in communication is because of the challenge we have in understanding one another. To refine our definition of communication, we can say that human communication is the process of making sense out of the world and sharing that sense with others by creating meaning through verbal and nonverbal messages. We make sense out of the world by listening, by observing, testing, touching, and smelling, then sharing our conclusions with others with both words and spoken expressions. As we have noted, the message sent may not be the same message that is understood because meaning is created in the heart and mind of the listener. In reality, meaning is created by both the speaker and listener. By this, we can mean that all individuals who are involved in the communication process shape how a message is understood by drawing upon their own experiences while attempting to make sense out of a message. It is because of the ever-present potential for misunderstanding that effective and appropriate communication should be other-oriented. In other words, effective communication acknowledges the perspective of others, not just the creator of the message. Communication that does not consider the needs, background, and culture of the receiver is more likely to be misunderstood. Knowing something about the experiences of the person or persons you're speaking to can help you communicate more effectively and appropriately. In this video, we have learned that 1. Communication is a process of making sense out of the world and sharing that sense with others by creating meaning through verbal and nonverbal messages. 2. That information is not communication. And 3. The importance of being other-oriented so that communication will be effective. In the next video, we will answer questions like, what does it mean to communicate competently? Does it mean that you are able to present well-delivered speech? Or that you are able to carry on a brilliant conversation with someone? Is evidence of your competence the fact that you are usually asked to chair a committee meeting because you are so organized? In the next video, we will talk about communication competence. Well, that's all for now, and I hope that you can join me next time in the next video lecture.